education, specifically in preschools. In preschools, according to ECDA, it is time spent outdoors in outdoor play, in active play. So children will require the minimum amount of about an hour daily of playtime outside, because it is believed that children indeed learn through play. Now, when children learn through play, what do they actually learn? So physical education has things that it covers for obesity and the things that it kind of lacks. So what does it cover? It does cover physical abilities like activeness, and it gets children involved in physical activities. But what does it not cover is, most importantly, that children are not really educated on why they need to eat healthy. They are also not aware of why is it important to manage their diet. And most importantly, they do not understand their proper food intake and what impacts it has on their bodies. So now, what are the possible leading factors to obesity? Why does it start in the first place, and why is it prevalent in Singapore? So some of the possible factors that are firstly, fast-paced life. Now, the life in Singapore is very fast-paced, and this can be seen when children actually have long school hours and adults have longer working hours as well. Now, how does this affect, how does this lead to obesity? Well, when one has a fast-paced life, they tend to not really take into consideration what they eat. So what parents are most likely to do is they are most likely to provide children with simple and very fast foods. And this leads to my second point, which is parents have limited time to look after their children in terms of food intake. Now, according to Lancet 2014, it is not a surprise that limited time parental engagement with their children is a factor of obesity. And it is also known that sedentary lifestyle is a factor that leads to obesity, because children now are spending more time on their technologies, on their headphones, and are less active outside. And this can also be seen with their parents, because parents can also be seen at home with their children and not really encouraging physical activeness outside. Now, what are other strategies that can be done to overcome obesity? The first way is that to educate them on the importance of health. Secondly, guiding them on how to manage their weight. And thirdly, family support and involvement is very, very important. Now, the first point, educating them on the importance of health. Now, why is it important to educate children on the importance of health to overcome obesity? Well, through educating them on the importance of health, they will understand why is there a need for them to eat healthily, so they're not doing it blindly, or they're not doing it and they're not growing up with the understanding that I'm just doing this because my parents taught me to. So they understand, and they are more encouraged and motivated to continue eating healthy. And actually, this can actually prevent obesity because of the mindset and positivity that they have with eating healthy. Secondly, guided on weight management. Now, when we're talking about preschoolers, of course, they are too young to actually plan out